So eto, let me just end with this story. Eto, shinare ko na to before, but I don't know if you can still remember, pero feeling ko akma to sa situation na to. 2 minutes na lang, just to share this story. This is called The Mountain Man. This is the story of Dashrathman He. Okay, so pwede bang makita lang, thumbs up lang kung narinig nyo na po itong story na to. Thumbs up lang po sa mga nakikinig ngayon para limaramang po kung nakikinig pa kayo. Okay, wala. Okay, so good. At least most of you have not heard this story or have forgotten this story. This is the story entitled The Man Who Actually Moved a Mountain. So Dashrathman, he was actually a poor man. He was a very simple man. In fact,
he was actually really poor. And he was living in a
poverty-stricken village of Gilur in India. One day, his wife went to him to the mountain to bring him food. But unfortunately, na-aksidente ang kanyang asawa po at nadulas at nahulog sa bangin. So with that happening, Dashrath was informed by his villagers or co-villagers. And so he rushed his wife to the hospital. Unfortunately, that hospital was 70 kilometers away from their village. It was actually blocked by a huge mountain path. Kaya kailangan pa nilang umikot. Imagine this in the picture. Kung magkokotse po kayo, 38 minutes yan. Pero sila Dashrath, wala silang kotse. Meron sila donkey, tsaka yung, tawag dito, yung parang kalesa. Di ba? So it took him more than 38 minutes. And because of that, namatay ang kanyang asawa. Buti na lang, fortunate na nasave nila yung anak nilang babae na pinagbubuntis no asawa niya. And you know what did Dashrath do? Because of that, Dashrath made a commitment to himself. He said that in loving memory of his wife, he's determined to put a hole inside that mountain. Bubutasin ko yung bundok para sa asawa ko so that wala na akong maghihirap na mga villagers at wala na matulad sa asawa ko. That way, hindi na namin kailangan umikot ng bundok. Tatagos na lang kami sa bundok. But the problem was Dashrath was not rich. Wala siyang pambili ng mga power tools, drills, wala siyang truck. Ang meron lang si Dashrath was a hammer and a chisel. Okay, just to show you, ito po ang itsura ni Dashrath. At yan po yung tools na ginagamit niya nung binutas niya po yung bundok. Ba, imagine nyo, ganyan ang gagamitin mo pambutas ng bundok. Baka pader pa lang magsumuko ka na, bundok pa kaya. And you know what? True enough, because that was all his only tools. Did you know how long it took him to actually carve the mountain? It took him 22 years of hard work and labor. Imagine yun, 22 years kang bubutasin mo yung bundok. And this is 22 years of not just struggle in terms of physical, ah, pero emotional din. Bakit? Kasi lahat ng kamag-anak niya, kasama niya sa village, lahat na nakakakilala sa kanya, pinagtatawanan siya, iniisip siyang baliw. Kasi imagine mo naman, lapitan ka na isang tao na namatay ang asawa at sabihin niya sa'yo, bubutasin ko yung bundok. Iisipin mo talaga, baliw tong taong ito. At gamit pa niya is only hammer and chisel. But you know what? He was so determined and he was so committed to his commitment and in memory of his wife because he knew what his purpose was. His purpose was, wag na maulit to sa ibang tao. And I want to honor my wife. I love my wife. So what did he do? From this, diba, he progressed unti-unti until he was able to put a hole in the mountain. Ito na po yung itsura nun. Na dinadaanan po ng tao, dinadaanan na ng kotse. Dashrathman, he carved a 360 feet long path through a mountain for 22 years using only a hammer and a chisel to reduce the distance between his village from 55 kilometers to be exact, to only 15 kilometers, ensuring that no one would die like his wife because they could not get medical care. And thus, his story was called A Poor Man's Labor of Love. And I'm sharing this with you because it's very simple. What is your purpose? Why are you doing these things? I guess you have to be reminded of what is your love for doing Sun Life? What is your great purpose? Because no matter how things get rough, if you know what you love and you have a reason, a deep reason for doing it, you will always stick to that reason. And you will always pursue and you will always succeed at the end. And there will be no regrets. So, sabi nga ni Brody Ashton, di ba? Heroes are made by the path they choose, not the power they produce. It's not because we are talented. It's not because we are skilled to begin with. It's because we chose to pursue a path and we chose to persevere. We were persistent, we had grit, and everything else we learned along the way, we became better, and we become who the person we are today.